It's a familiar early morning scene played out in households everywhere. But besides getting his kids dressed and then dropping them off at school, Jason Koger of Owensboro, Kentucky, also must get himself ready. That means making some important decisions about what he's going to be wearing today.
Being a bilateral amputee, you have to use prosthetics. You know, if you're a single-arm amputee, you have the ability to use a real hand to help. You know, it's kind of like a tool for them.
Near San Diego, California, Katie Walker is putting her newest tool to the test. This Paralympic hopeful is trying out a new innovation in prosthetics, customized personally for her specific needs on the field.
The difference is the little wrist unit. It actually, the bat attachment pops off.
All right.
And this bat attachment, actually, the bat handle goes right inside of here. So it's supposed to, after I swing, after I follow through, I can just pop it right off.
And then run to first base.
And then start running.
And then rotate around. Cool.
For upper limb amputees like Jason and Katie, gone are the days of hook and cable arms. In labs like this one at Advanced Arm Dynamics outside Dallas, Texas, technicians work alongside occupational therapists to custom design prosthetics driven by patients' dreams.
Just really cool to really have an opportunity to see a patient, see what they need, and actually do what they need. Not just say, well, all we have is this, I'm sorry, here you go. So we get to be really creative.
Now, thanks to myoelectronic advances, the technology does bring patients closer to experiencing the full range of hand mobility most of us take for granted. One of the most sophisticated prosthetics on the market, the iLimb Ultra Revolution, allows users to move through a series of grips, even the ability to rotate the thumb. And there's even an app for that.
Let's put these electrodes on you.
What are these electrodes measuring?
So these electrodes are sensing your muscle contracting. You're now bionic.
I'm now bionic. I feel so powerful. So right now, I should be able to control this robotic hand just by moving my muscles.
So did you see that big red spike? So the hand's operating. And now I want you to do is make a closing. Okay, so that was blue.
Inside, the hand is powered by an intricate network of tiny wires attached to 6 motors that allow each finger to articulate separately. 24 advanced grips are now possible, with a total grip force of about 7 pounds. The arm is powered by a battery with an 1800 cycle or approximately 8 to 10 hour charge. That's been extended by up to 25% in the Ultra Revolution.
And what is the most challenging part of this technology?
It's matching the technology with the patient. We want to pair technology with the right type of patient.
How's it going?
Hey, good morning.
Hey.
Katie is working with our team up in Portland. She was born without her hand, and so she's worn prosthetic devices throughout her life, but she's gotten interested in the Paralympics. She wants to track and field.
So this one, how does it different than the one you normally use?
Well, first off, it's much lighter, but it's made of carbon fiber, and the socket, it's really comfortable and sweat-proof. And it's really made for the starting blocks.
Yeah.
So it helps me get down. Here, I can show you.
Ready, Mark? Set. Go.
Katie was born in Taiwan with a congenital condition. Like many amputees who have grown up without, she was concerned about comfort.
At 16, you started using a prosthetic.
I did, yes.
What was the reason?
So I knew I was going off to college soon. So I really wanted people's first impression of me not to be a person with a disability or an amputation, but also just wanted to see how it would feel like to have two hands or the closest thing that I could.
The iLimb technology is currently the closest many patients can come to the dexterity of a real hand. For Jason Koger, the tiniest household tasks are now possible for the first time.
I'm gonna try, I ain't never done it before.
Despite having lost both of his arms in an electrical accident, Jason is willing to try just about anything, sometimes using his more durable hooks around the farm, other times with his iLimbs. Jason has become sort of a field tester, making him one of the first people in the entire world to have two bionic arms.
Jason's one of those rare birds that not only has the motivation and the will to move forward, but he has a great personality. And he's willing to talk to other people about his experience, what he's been through, the good, the bad, the ugly.
Where would you like to see the technology go?
They've told me things that they're wanting to get into single nerves. They're wanting to be able, one nerve, to move one finger.
It's called target muscle reinnervation, where a targeted muscle is denervated. Then, nerves from the residual limb are harvested and transplanted into that area. If the procedure is successful, sensor electrodes will read the nerves, then send signals directly to the artificial limb, allowing the hand to perform multiple actions simultaneously and intuitively.
It's not like it's, you know, that would be nice, but it's real, and they're starting to implement that in the laboratory setting, and eventually we'll make it out to a human being.
Until then, Katie Walker is training hard for the 100-meter sprint. She hopes to compete in the 2016 Paralympics in Brazil. And Jason? Well, he's searching for the next thing someone tries to tell him he can't do.
You know, I try to inspire people every day because I think people give up way too easy. I do what I do because I want to do it. I'm not Superman, you know, I'm just Jason Koger, you know.